What does depression look like to you? For some people, it looks like someone who can't get out of bed in the morning, or someone who's constantly crying. And for many, depression gets serious when a person is unable to actually hold down a job, or to go out and see their friends because they're too depressed. But what if I told you that depression isn't just lying around in bed crying all the time? Depression does not look the same for everyone. Some people are actually able to hold down jobs, smile with their friends, and suffer from a persistent yet mild depression. This video is going to be explaining some of the signs and symptoms of something called high-functioning depression. Before we talk about the specific type of depression, I want to define what makes someone depressed. Depression is technically a group of conditions classified by the elevation or lowering of someone's mood. Bipolar depression, clinical depression, and postpartum depression are all conditions that fit under this umbrella. And when most people think of depression, they think of major depressive disorder, or clinical depression. This is a condition characterized by persistent, severe, depressed mood. Someone experiencing clinical depression may lose interest in their activities, lose interest in life altogether, and be severely impaired. This impairment makes it hard to go to work, get out of bed, or just enjoy everyday activities. But what about high-functioning depression? Because major depression is not only one form of depression. Someone may also experience high-functioning depression, or something called persistent depressive disorder. High-functioning depression does not mean that someone is super talented at math or able to function at a higher degree than others. On the surface, someone experiencing high-functioning depression is simply going about their day. High-functioning depression is a mild, yet persistent, depressive disorder that lasts 2 or more years. And while someone may experience a loss of interest in activities they may usually enjoy, they're still able to go about their daily routine or head to work. However, doing so may just take a lot of extra energy. So let's get into the meat of this video. Let's go over some signs of high-functioning depression. Remember, depression looks different on everyone. And if someone is showing only some of these 5 symptoms, they may still need to reach out to a professional. So the first one is lack of energy or fatigue. Major depressive disorder is often characterized by the inability to get out of bed. The simple idea of getting out of bed, showering, or facing the world is a lot for someone with depression to handle. This also occurs in mild depression, but in a more milder form. Someone with mild depression may be actually able to get out of bed, but for them it takes a lot of energy. They may be able to shower and go to work, but again, it takes a lot more energy and effort on their part. These big tasks eventually wear on someone, leaving little energy for other activities that they might have normally enjoyed, like hobbies, passions, and time out with friends. That might be too exhausting. Second up on our list, we have feelings of hopelessness, worry, or guilt. Someone with high-functioning depression may be so focused thinking about their worries or guilt. From the moment they wake up, this person may feel guilty about how little they're getting done. They may worry that they're not good enough. They may feel not worthy, that nothing they can do can change the state of the world or make their lives or their friends or family any better. These feelings are exhausting when they're all that's running through your head. So that's sign number 2, feelings of hopelessness, worry, or guilt, or other negative emotions. Number 3 is difficulty concentrating or focusing. If you're weighed down with worry or guilt, it can be really difficult to focus on anything else. Someone with high-functioning depression may be able to get to their job, but completing it to the best of their ability isn't so easy. They may try to focus on a project, but they can't. This leads to even more guilt and worry, which makes it even more difficult to focus. In the end, it's an unfortunate spiral that continues unless the person can take action. And these actions may include meditation, healthy coping mechanisms, or mindfulness practice, and especially reaching out to a professional. Number 4 is irritability. See, depression isn't only expressed through sadness. Someone may be extremely irritable as a way to mask those feelings of guilt, frustration, or worry that they may be experiencing. In many cases, depression is often overlooked in people who are just irritable. When women are irritable, they are often written off as moody. Yet, women are actually more likely to experience irritability if they're experiencing persistent depressive disorder. And while men may not always be classified as irritable, flashes of intense rage may be a sign that inside they're facing a depressed mood or some serious anxiety. And lastly on the list, we have excessive drinking, exercise, or some other unhealthy coping mechanisms. Because another way of masking those feelings of guilt or worry is to resort to unhealthy coping mechanisms. In fact, substance abuse and depression are often linked. Someone may also resort to excessive exercise, overeating, or undereating. And a common sign is quick fluctuations in weight, sudden weight loss, or weight gain. These are all signs that someone may be experiencing a form of depression. So as a review, the 5 signs are lack of energy or fatigue, feelings of hopelessness, worry, or guilt, difficulty concentrating or focusing, irritability, and any other signs of unhealthy coping mechanisms. So what do you do if you're experiencing some of these signs? Well, In short, you can and should seek some form of treatment. Because although mild depressive disorders does not sound as serious as major depressive disorder, it should not be overlooked. High-functioning depression can still hold a person back from enjoying their life and reaching their full potential. Fortunately, there are ways for people with high-functioning depression to overcome symptoms and live a happy, better life. Healthy coping mechanisms can replace unhealthy ones. One of the best things is regular appointments with a therapist or a professional can give someone the tools and skills necessary to alleviate those feelings of worry or guilt and maybe look into them. There's also medications and other forms of treatment that are also available. Ending this video, I want to let you know that depression is nothing to be ashamed of or run away from. Over 250 million people throughout the world experience some form of depression, whether it's mild, major, or something else. And if you think that you may have depression, I've actually created a depression inventory test on my website that you can take completely free to give you more insight into how severe or persistent your feelings actually are. Regardless, if you feel as though you are struggling, do not be afraid to seek help. One last little note, if you're experiencing a few of these symptoms, you might want to take the depression test that I just developed and put up on my website. It helps you recognize depressive symptoms, since a lot of times, especially if you have high-functioning depression, you may not see those symptoms until someone else points them out. If you want to take that test and maybe see what you score on it, there's a link in the description. It takes around 5 minutes to complete, and it's completely free. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope that maybe I've helped someone be a little more self-aware with this video. And if you have any questions at all, feel free to leave a comment below. Thanks for watching!